In this video, I'm going to show you how to deploy Huawei Router AR1000V on EVE NG. I have EVE NG installed in VMware, a workstation player. Let's select the VM and click play virtual machine. I've posted the link to EVE NG community cookbook down this video for more information about EVE NG VM installation. After startup of the VM, I'm gonna open my web browser and log in to the virtual machine of EVE using the IP address shown in the VMware window, which is 192.168.129.142. This is the IP address of EVE VM. Let's open the web browser and connect using this IP address, which is 192.168.129.142. This is our login page. We use our login credentials. The default username is admin and password is Eve. Let's use HTML file console and click sign. We have here the Eve NG login page already displayed, and we successfully logged in. And now this is the main page after login. Let's add new lab and name it as Huawei lab. Then click save. Now, this is the page of the lab. We should here drop Huawei routers. But before we drop Huawei routers, we have to make sure that the image for Huawei router is already given to the EVE VM. So let's open an SSH connection to open the terminal of the EVE VM and go to the image path. The image path is /opt/unitlab/addons/QEMU. Here we have the image directories. In the image directories, we have here Huawei AR1005.170. Let's go to it. This is the image file, hda.qcow2. I have also posted the link of EVE-NG for how to install this image, the Huawei image, and give it to the EVE VM in the correct path and required path down this video. After the image is already added here, we can go back to the lab and add an object node and select Huawei AR1000V. It's available. We select it and let's name it as AR1000V1 as a router one. The required RAM is 2 giga, and Ethernet, let's change it to 3 Ethernet interfaces, which are quite enough for us in this lab. And we change from console to telnet and click save. This is the first router. Let's add another router using same way. Three interfaces. And from console to telnet, then click save. Let's also add another device, which is a switch. It's already a Cisco switch, already added here. Cisco iOS 372. Let's name this device as switch and give one to it. Megabytes RAM is quite enough for it. And click save. We can also change the icon of this device from a router to a switch. Yeah, let's use the icon of the layer 3 switch. And also let's add another slot for this device, which is 16 Ethernet ports. So we have multiple of Ethernet ports available for more connections. Then we connect the router to this switch. Here we have the connection request wizard appears. We need now to connect router one to the switch using these interfaces. This is the available interfaces we have for router AR1000V, three interfaces. Let's select the first interface, which is 0/0/0, and connect the switch to fast Ethernet 1/0. We have two modules for this switch available, module 0 and module 1. Module 0 is used for routed interfaces. So let's avoid this because we are not using this device as a router. We are using it as a switch. So let's use the second module already added when we selected this switch. So let's change to fast Ethernet 1/0 and click save. And connect the other router using same way, 0/0/0, and use 1/1. 1/0 is already connected between AR router one and this switch. So let's use the other port, the second port, which is 1/1. Then click save. Now it's time to start the devices. Simply right click on the router and click start. So now if we need to connect to the console of the router, we just double click on it. The nodes take several minutes to finish startup and loading. In the next video, I will add Ubuntu Linux desktop to the lab and add and make an initiate SSH session from the Ubuntu server to the AR router and show you how to get in the Huawei router and configure it in Eve lab. Thank you for viewing this video. I hope it can be a good value for you.